Oh, hello. Sorry, I didn't know we're recording. It's Uncle Matt here. I'm just brushing my teeth. I'm going to the dentist tomorrow, so I want to make sure that, you know, all that plaque is gone, and I don't want any cavities. Oh, I'm a little embarrassed. Didn't know we were recording yet. Well, how about I read you a story? That's kind of what you're used to, and this here is sort of like a dentist chair. Sorta. Oh, let me just get ready. Oh, much better. And my teeth feel good. Well, we're gonna read a bedtime story. It's Uncle Matt reading you a bedtime story. Tonight's bedtime story, in anticipation for going to the dentist tomorrow, I'm gonna read Curious George Visits the Dentist. This book was copyright in 2014. Are you ready? Here we go. George was a good little monkey and always very curious. When he visited his neighbor, Mrs. Ross, he was especially curious about her gleaming basket of fruit. That bright red apple on top looked too perfect to be true. And it was. George bit into it and discovered that it was hard and sticky and not sweet. Oh dear, said Mrs. Ross, that's not a real apple, George. It's made of wax. George's tooth began to hurt. You should always ask before eating something, George, the man with the yellow hat reminded him. By the time he went to bed that evening, George's tooth was less sore, but the next morning his tooth was wobbly. His mouth felt so strange that George couldn't even enjoy his favorite pancake breakfast. We should see the dentist, George, the man said. She can make sure that tooth of yours is all right. The man explained that the dentist was a doctor for teeth, but George didn't want anyone to touch his tooth. What if it hurt? George walked along the path to the dentist's office with his friend, his steps getting slower and slower until he ran off to pick a daisy. That's very pretty, said the man chasing after George, but we have an appointment and we shouldn't be late. You'll be a good little monkey, won't you? George nodded. He always wanted to be good. The waiting room was a welcoming place. There were lots of things to see and do. One by one, the young patients were called away by a woman in a white suit. George watched them go through a red door, each holding on to a grown-up's hand. One frightened boy was carried in by his mother. George was glad he wouldn't have to see the dentist by himself. George, you're next, the woman announced. George was sad to put down his book, but he was also a little curious about where the children were going. Was there a play area on the other side? The examining room was not filled with toys, but it was still interesting. There was a sink and a long chair for lying down. There was a stool for the dentist and a light above the chair. George was curious. Why were there two faucets in the room? Hello, George. I'm Dr. Wang. It's nice to meet you, she said. Why don't you lie down and we'll take a look at your teeth? George saw a row of silver dental exam tools on the counter. They were long, shiny, and pointy. He hid behind the man. George, would you like me to try out the chair first? The man asked. Great idea, said Dr. Wang. The man lay down. Open your mouth wide. The dentist shined the big light down into the man's mouth. She took out a small white instrument to take a closer look at each tooth. "This is a mouth mirror." George watched. It didn't look too scary. "Next, I'll count the teeth," Dr. Wang told George. She picked up one of those sharp, pointy tools. "This is an explorer. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then the man exclaimed, "Ow!" "Uh-oh," the dentist said, and George ran away. He left the exam room and scurried down the hall. There were many doors. He didn't know which was the way out. He tried one door and walked into another exam room. "A monkey," a little girl cried and jumped off the exam chair in excitement as George backed out of the room. He continued down the hall, opening doors and disturbing patients. In one room, the scared little boy from the reception area was crying. George had an idea. He jumped onto a table and began juggling packs of dental floss. The little boy stopped crying and smiled. Next, George leaped over to the sink in the middle of the room. He pushed a button and the nearby water jet spurted, spraying water around the room. George squirted water into his own mouth and into the boy's mouth, too. Next, George decided to switch on an overhead lamp. But the lamp tumbled over, spilling George safely to the floor. The boy clapped, but Dr. Wang stood in the doorway. "George, you naughty monkey," Dr. Wang said. "What a mess you've made." This monkey was the only one who could get Tyler to stop crying, the boy's mother said. Dr. Wang considered. She said, "It does look like we have some eager young patients, and if it weren't for you, George, I wouldn't have found the cavity in your friend's mouth." "Turns out I need to have a filling," the man with the yellow hat said. "Come on, George, let's both get our teeth checked." As soon as Dr. Wang looked into George's mouth, she laughed. "Why, George, all you have is a loose tooth." A loose tooth sounded worrisome to George. "It's going to fall out soon. There's a new permanent tooth right behind it. Looks like you've been doing a good job brushing your teeth." George jumped on his chair. He did. He brushed every night and morning. "Keep brushing and don't eat too many sweets," the dentist reminded him. "You want your teeth to be in good shape for the tooth fairy." George waved goodbye to his new friends. He went home with a new toothbrush, some dental floss, and instructions for his loose tooth. He should bite into as many hard apples as he could, as long as they were real, of course. He decided he didn't mind going to the dentist at all. That night, he ate a healthy dinner with an apple for dessert. His tooth fell out with his second bite. He put his tooth under his pillow. The next morning, George found a special coin in his tooth's place. When Mrs. Ross came to check on George that afternoon, George proudly showed her his coin from the tooth fairy. Mrs. Ross laughed and said, "Well, that was a quick way to lose a tooth, but I don't recommend it next time." The end. Well, I am so glad George turned out okay, even after visiting the dentist, which I'm doing tomorrow. But I don't know about you. Are you scared about going to the dentist sometimes? Usually it turns out pretty good. I get some free stuff too, like a toothbrush. Maybe some floss. Well, that's all the time we have for Uncle Matt's Bedtime Story. I hope you enjoyed that story, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.